أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس، ومن يفعل ذلك ابتغاء مرضات الله فسوف نؤتيه أجرا عظيما. ومن يشاقق الرسول من بعد ما تبين له الهدى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين نوله ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساءت مصيرا. إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء، ومن يشرك بالله فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا. إن يدعون من دونه إلا إناثا وإن يدعون إلا شيطانا مريدا لعنه الله، وقال لأتخذن من عبادك نصيبا مفروضا. ولأضلنهم ولأمنينهم ولآمرنهم فليبتكن آذان الأنعام ولآمرنهم فليغيرن خلق الله. ومن يتخذ الشيطان وليا من دون الله فقد خسر خسرانا مبينا. يعدهم ويمنيهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا. أولئك مأواهم جهنم ولا يجدون عنها محيصا. والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات سندخلهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا، وعد الله حقا، ومن أصدق من الله قيلا. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. First of all, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was making dua against the kuffar, and because of one of the incidents, the companion said he was making dua 1 month. 1 month, because an incident happened. And one day they killed some of the Muslims, some of the Qurra. So this means we need the dua for a long time. Okay, they are not killing the Muslims there in Gaza for 1 day or for 2 days. They keep killing them now, it is 21 days. And subhanAllah, the victims, more than 7,000. So we should not forget the dua. We should focus the dua on the kuffar and to save the Muslims. The Prophet ﷺ was saying, Allahumma anji fulan, Allahumma anji, oh Allah, save so and so, save so and so, save so and so. Allahumma alayka bi kada kada, oh Allah, be against so and so and this country or this village. Well, for 1 month after the ruku' and the salah. Okay, and there is narration after every salah. Fajr, Zuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Maybe you notice some imam, they are doing Maghrib and Fajr, or okay, because a narration, Fajr, narration, Fajr, Maghrib, narration, all the Salah. Fajr, Zuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. The imam can do the dua, the last rak'ah after the ruku'. And we raise the hand and we say Ameen. Not only there, also in our Salah. Also in our Salah, we can do the, we do the dua for our brothers and Muslim brothers and sisters. And you notice now, subhanallah, we see the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tada'a alaykum umam kama tada'a al-akala ila qas'atiha. The nations call each other, like when people they call invite each other for أواليم أو فراميل، سبحان الله. They come and they eat the food. You see the non-Muslim nations, they unite against the Muslims. Against the Muslims. يعني it is very clear that the innocent are killed. When there is one baby here or there, or there is one woman, you find them shouting and calling for the woman's right, the baby right. Now, how many babies are killed? How many Muslims, how many innocent are killed? Subhanallah. اللهم استعان، يا الله بروتكت. Yes, yes, loudly. He can recite the dua loudly. فجر، ظهر، عصر، مغرب، عشاء. طيب، سورة النساء، verse number 114. We started this ayah and continue inshallah. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala here, لا خير في كثير. No good is there in much of their private conversation except for those who enjoin charity or that which is right or conciliation between people. And whoever does that seeking means to the approval of Allah, then we are going to give him a great reward. We mentioned this ayah last week, the benefits from this ayah. So this ayah encourages us to do the good deeds. Any good deed, you do it. And also, we learn from this ayah that the private conversation, usually this is the way of the hypocrites. Why? Because they have secrets. They hide the shar, the evil, and the disbelief. So they like to do the private conversation. So this is the way, basically, this is the way of the hypocrites. But for the believers, if they like to do it, they will do it for the khair. We have a private conversation for khair. How to build a masjid, how to unite the Muslim ummah, how to help so and so. So it is for good things. And also this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, بصدقه. بصدقه. Okay? It doesn't specify a kind of charity. It is open. For any kind of charity. So there is sadaqah on yourself. Okay, you know the Prophet ﷺ was asked, O Rasulullah, I have 1 dinar. Okay, on yourself. I have 1 dinar, your family. 1 dinar, yani, which means one more dinar for others. So also it is a charity when you give yourself. When you buy a food for yourself, because wallah, I want to fast tomorrow, so I buy the bread on meal, suhoor. I'm fasting, so I want to break my fast. I go and I buy some leban, some dates to eat, to drink. This is also a kind of charity. So sadaqa ala nafs. Okay? So, and also it is also the charity for others. Also the charity in telling people to do the good, amr ma'roof, and to avoid the bad, nahy al munkar. This is also charity, sadaqa. Also the good word, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-kalima al-tayyiba sadaqa, the good word is sadaqa. When you stop the evil, when you stop harming others, this is also sadaqa. This is a charity. Also that when you give knowledge, when you spread knowledge, this is also a kind of sadaqah. I learn day and night, or I learn something useful, something from a hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, بَلِّغُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةٍ, convey even one ayah from me. This is also sadaqah of your knowledge. So also your effort. This is also sadaqah. Someone needs to push a car, you help him to push a car, to carry his items, you help him to carry the things. This is also sadaqah. So the concept of sadaqah is very wide. Also from this ayah, it encourages us to do the good. يعني المبادرة. Don't wait someone to ask you. You start from yourself to do the good things. This should be the Muslim. The Muslim likes to start doing the good things for others. not waiting someone to ask him. From myself, I start helping the others. Also here, what do you notice? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ فَسَوْفَ نُؤْتِيهِ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. طيب, then we are going to give him a great reward, the one who does so. There is result, there is no result. Okay, this will not affect your reward. When I give charity, okay, maybe sometimes you give charity, but no one will use it. طيب. Or something happens to damage your charity. You will not get the reward, you will get the reward. I bought water. I put the water, for example, here in the masjid. Then something, or let's say I put juice in the fridge. It is summer, the fridge outside. It is summer. I put it in the night. Why? Because or after Fajr, I want people afternoon to drink the juice. But subhanAllah, I don't know that the fridge is not working. So the noon time spoiled. Or I put leban, for example, milk. Too hot. So no one benefits from this charity. You will not get the reward. You will get the reward. You will get the reward, whatever your the result. Also, we learn from this ayah that we should be careful from these secret or private meetings. The Muslim basically should be open. I have a kind of khair, I should be open. I have a class, do it openly. Okay, why you try to hide here and there? You don't like people to know about your classes, your da'wah. Are you doing something wrong? This is the way, as we said, this is the way of the hypocrites, basically. But if it is needed, and for example, I have, like the Prophet ﷺ used to do the meetings with Abu Bakr and Umar. There are issues not suitable for everyone to share their opinion. No, I need specific people to have the opinion, their opinions, their suggestions. Okay, so basically, we should keep our things open. Why you hide your da'wah? Do you have something wrong? Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said hadith, "Wal ithmu ma haka fi sadrika wa karihta an yattali' alayhi an-nas." What is the sin? That you have something in your heart to define, sometimes to know this is right or wrong. Okay, yes, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said halal bayyin, haram bayyin. Halal is clear, haram is clear. But sometimes there is something, maybe you don't have a proof for that. Or maybe you don't have knowledge, a great knowledge to be sure this is haram or this is halal. طيب. So what kind of sign that you have to tell you this is haram or halal? Okay, when you do this, do you like people to see you? Or you like to do it alone? So when you have this kind of feeling, I don't want people to know about this behavior or this action. Okay, so the Prophet ﷺ said, وَإِثْمُ مَا حَاكَ فِي صَدْرِكَ. The sin, it has something new, like a feeling not to do it. وَكَرِهْتَ أَنْ يَطَّلِعَ عَلَيْهِ النَّاسِ. You hate that people to see you while doing this action. So this is a sign telling you what you are doing haram. So what is the meaning of that? Why you are not doing this openly? No, I have a class, I should do it. No, not here. Let's go inside the room. Okay, maybe sometimes you like to do inside the room of the masjid because you don't want to disturb maybe people reading Quran. But if there is nothing like that, why you hide? Why you don't declare? Why you are not posting a flyer? Why not calling why you are not calling people for your da'wah, for your meetings? Sometimes they don't call people. Why? Because they know they are doing something wrong or speaking something bad. So this is the way of the hypocrites. Also, we can understand from this ayah that the ibadat, okay, some of the ibadat, it's better to hide them, like giving charity. Which is better? You give charity openly, publicly, or in a hidden way? Basically, you do it in a hidden way. طيب ان تبدوا صدقات في نعيمها وان تخفوها وتؤتوها الفقراء، يعني okay, if you declare your charity, no problem. I mean, when you do it openly, no problem with that. Okay, there is someone poor. Okay, I give him 1 dinar. حرام؟ Not حرام. This is good. Jazakallah khair. You are helping. But if you do it in a hidden way, this will be more reward, inshallah. Okay, how? يعني maybe you wait people until they leave. Then you give him, or in an indirect way. طيب. So, some ibadat, it's better you do it in Qiyam al-Layl, which is better. You do Qiyam al-Layl here in the masjid, after Isha, people see you praying, or you go home and you pray at home. It's better you pray at home, Qiyam al-Layl, okay, or any sunnah. It's better to do it at home. خير صلاة المرء في بيتي إلا المكتوبة. The best for the person to pray at home, except the fard. The fard in the masjid. So here, also, the types of the good deeds, there is one time the benefit for a person, one person, and there is some kind for others also. So which is better, when the benefit is only for the one who's doing, or it is mutaaddi, can be used also for others. When more people are benefit from the deed, the reward will be more. Okay, because now the charity, the benefit for yourself or for others also, or also for others. So this is more reward. The spreading knowledge, teaching, for the person himself or for others, also for others. So the reward will be more. The reward will be more. If you have two things now, I sit at home and read Quran, or I teach people. Okay, you teach people. Okay, if you have no knowledge to teach. Also, we learn from this ayah, we should be careful from those who are doing their private meetings. We should be careful. Okay, when they are doing anything, they try to do it in a private way. They are not doing anything publicly, anything open. Okay, we should be careful. As we said, because this is the way of the hypocrites. Okay, again, it doesn't mean haram to do a private meeting. Because sometimes I have a very sensitive issue. I cannot share with everyone. So, yes. And also the virtue of reconciliation among people, especially the husband and wife. This is one of the great deeds. Also, we learn from this ayah that the righteous deed will not be useful for the person without the good intention. Okay, why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, He said, ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ, seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So without the good intention, it is useless. It is useless. And also, we learn from this ayah that we should protect the Muslim community from those people who are trying to betray the Muslim ummah, the hypocrites. This is very, very important that the Muslim as a person, or the Muslim community, should pay attention for those who are trying to destroy the Muslim ummah from inside. Okay, this is not correct that to think good about everyone. I think good about everyone. Habibi, he is doing something. We should be careful. All of his meetings with certain people and a hidden way, they are not sitting with us at all. We should be careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, khudhu hidrakum, take your precautions. The Muslim should not be like anyone can come and hit him on the head or on his back, and always he is miskeen. We should be brave. We should pay attention. We should alert. We should, okay, take our precautions. And also, we learn from this ayah that لا يعني ذا آية الله سبحانه لا خير في كثير من نجواهم. If there is private conversation, it means it is one person or a group. Group. Okay, so the basic rule that being in a group or يعني being with people is better than being alone. How? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, المسلم الذي يخالط الناس ويصبر على أداهم خير من الذي لا يخالط الناس ولا يصبر على أداهم. The believer who's with people, mixing with people, okay? And of course, when you live with people, you will hear something bad sometimes. They harm you, but you are patient. You'll get more reward than the one who's more than the reward, more than the believer who's not sitting with people, isolating himself. Because you know, sometimes you hear people say, huh, we don't see you in the halqa, we don't see you in this picnic. I like from the masjid to home. I don't like to sit with people, because when I sit with people, he will say that, he will discuss me, he will fight with me, let me alone, this is better. Okay, so no doubt, sitting alone, you'll be safe. Sitting alone, you'll be safe, خلاص. You are sitting with your book, with your tea, with your family, خلاص. No headache with of people. But you will lose reward. Sitting with people, يعني, like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. When he was with people, like the hypocrites, like Abdullah ibn Ubayy, he said bad things about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He bothered the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not say, خلاص, I will sit at home and do قيام الليل. With people. You will get the reward of being patient. This is something very important. So try your best to be with people if it is, of course, if it is not harmful. It needs patience. Okay, but if it reaches to a level that you cannot stop them, yani for example, I'm sitting with people, they are smoking cigarettes. I advise them they are not stopping smoking cigarettes. They are backbiting. Okay, or maybe they are causing harm to me. خلاص, you leave them, you go to another group. There is no other group. خلاص, I stay alone. You know, sometimes at work, maybe you are facing troubles with them. They are speaking bad about you. They are speaking bad about Muslims, causing troubles for you. So you go to another room and you sit alone. Or if there is a prayer room, you sit there after finishing your work. But basically, you should be patient with people. This is da'wah. This is the da'wah. Okay? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the next ayah. ومن يشاقق الرسول من بعد ما تبين له الهدى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين نولي ما تولى ونصلي جهنم وساءت مصيرا. This is a very important ayah. And whoever opposes the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم after guidance has become clear to him and follows other than the way of the believers, we will give him what he has taken and drive him into hell and evil it is as a destination. This is very important ayah. وَمَا يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ. What does it mean, وَمَا يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ? Here he said, opposes. And whoever opposes the messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم. يُشَاقِق, okay, from شِق. يعني that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on one side, and he is the other side. He is in one شِق, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on one شِق, and he is in another شِق. Another side. يشاقق. يعني you understand from this word to be in one side and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the other side. ومن يشاقق. يعني he's not going with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the same way, the same sunnah. ومن يشاقق الرسول. When? من بعد ما تبين له الهدى. After the guidance was very clear for him. Very clear. تبين. Wasn't تبين. Obvious, واضح, clear. Okay, this is sunnah. Where is the? This is the proof from the Quran. This is from the Hadith. This is from ijma. Very clear. ومن يشاقق الرسول من بعد ما تبين له الهدى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين and follows other than the way of the believers. As I said, this is a very important ayah as a clear proof about منهج السلف. منهج السلف. Because calling Quran Sunnah is not enough. You should say open the understanding of the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى. This is منهج السلف. Because you know sometimes people misuse calling to Quran and Sunnah. I follow Quran and Sunnah. Okay. How he is practicing that? He reads the Quran, he reads the Hadith, and he uses his own understanding. You'll find some people like that. And you'll find many followers. I am following Quran, Sunnah, declaring like that. Quran, Sunnah, Quran, Sunnah. Okay, so when people hear this, mashallah, this is very nice. Mashallah, this Sheikh always quoting Quran, Sunnah, Quran, Sunnah. Where is the companion generation? The scholars after the companions, tabi'in, tabi'in. Okay, what is the point? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. What is the meaning of this ayah? وَاتَّبِعَ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Okay, who were the believers here? Allah said the believers. Who were the believers? The Sahaba, the companions. So this is very important to follow the companions, the way of the companions. Okay, what does the ayah mean? Does the ayah mean that the Prophet ﷺ has one way, the companion has another way, so we have to do, to use both of the? No. The way of the companions, exactly, it is the way of the Prophet ﷺ. So we should know what it was the understanding of the companions. As I mentioned many times, brothers, when we when we see the those who are talking about al-ijaz al-ilmi, okay, the scientific proofs from the Quran and Sunnah, okay, or yeah, this they say scientific miracles. Look, this ayah talks about the cell, the protons, the neutron and this thing. For 1,400 years, the scholars did not understand the ayah very well. Now we understand. What do you mean? Do you mean that you are, your understanding is better than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Never. Your understanding was better than the companions? Never. They were the best people to understand the Quran. So we should be careful. Don't go outside the understanding of the companion. This is very important. وَيَتَّبِعَ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is the way of the believers. I have to stick to the way of the believers. This is the manhaj al-salaf. Hey, why say we have to follow manhaj al-salaf? From the Quran, the proofs, the Quran, the Sunnah. This is one of the clear proofs. To follow the manhaj al-salafi. Manhaj al-Salafi, Quran, Sunnah, understanding of the companions. رضي الله تعالى, the best generations. Sahaba, Tabi'in, Tabi' Tabi'in. And if you remember, Surah Al-Baqarah, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اهْتَدَوْا. If they believe in what you have believed in. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. Here, آمَنْتُمْ refers to companions. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِالْقُرْآنِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. If they believe in the book and the sunnah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. To tell you the importance of the understanding of the companions. طيب. وَمِنْ شَاقِقُ رَسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين. طيب. We will give him نوله ما تولى what he has taken ونصله جهنم. نوله ما تولى يعني what he is close to, he is trying to approach. نوله ما تولى, anything other than the way of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and the companions will be in the hellfire. It is only one way. The hadith حديث عرباض بن سارية رضي الله تعالى عنه, عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين من بعدي. Stick to my sunnah and the sunnah of the guided khalifa after me. Okay, so now when you maybe you read again the same thing, you understand that there is one sunnah for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, there is a different sunnah for the companions, the Khalifa after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. No, the hadith, عضوا بها, bite on it. It refers to one or more than one. One. Which means the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the sunnah of the companions is one thing. عضوا بها. So the same thing here. So this, the same thing, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wants to tell us the importance of following the companions. Stick to the religion of the companions, to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't mean they have a new religion, different religion. It is the same. It is the religion of Allah. Stick to their sunnah, to their way, to their understanding. This is very important. So that's why you will find the scholars of Salaf saying, Quran, sunnah, open the understanding of the Salaf, of the companions. This is very important. If you find anyone calling Quran, sunnah, without mentioning the names of the scholars, he is going astray. He is mubtadi. He is dhal, misguided. And also misguiding people. No, this is good sheikh. Good sheikh. How come good sheikh? I think I mentioned this. There's one famous sheikh. I don't know where is he now. He was, subhanAllah, he was teaching in Masjid al-Aqsa. And subhanAllah, many people listening to him. One of my colleagues at work, he liked him, subhanAllah. And subhanAllah, this is a friend. Sometime this sheikh, maybe for a few months, then he jumped to another sheikh. SubhanAllah, this is, for sure this is wrong. When you find a person jumping from one sheikh to another sheikh to another sheikh, of course I mean from one manhaj to another manhaj to another manhaj, for sure he is wrong. For sure he is wrong. Allah made Islam clear, but subhanAllah, people, they like sometimes to follow their desire, or they follow the one who speak in a nice way, whatever his manhaj, his way. So, no, this sheikh, Quran, sunnah. Quran, sunnah. Step by step, Quran, sunnah. I told him, okay, what about the shuyukh? What about the scholars? Can he mention one scholar? One scholar? Never. He will not mention one scholar. And of course, with time, he will not mention any companion. Okay, from where the Quran? This Quran. How now we have this Quran? Through the companions. And the generation after the companions. The generation after the tabi'in. From one generation to another generation. The Quran has narration, has chain. Has chain. Okay, yeah, and you'll find what we are reading in Kuwait, اللي هو حفص عن عاصم. طيب, what you will find, حفص, عاصم بن نجود, this from one scholar to another scholar to عثمان عفان, because this is مصحف عثماني. So from عثمان رضي الله عنه, from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So if you don't take from the scholars, so you don't have Quran, it means you don't have Sunnah. طيب, so claiming that, no, I am a human being and the companion human beings, so we are the same. We are not prophets. So my understanding, their understanding the same. He is destroying the deen. SubhanAllah. So he said here, subhanahu wa ta'ala, نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى. So he will be with what he is believing in him. وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ. We will burn him in Jahannam. طيب. Here it's the translation. And drive him into hell. Actually, here, وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ أَصْلِي, طيب, it doesn't mean to drive him to Jahannam. أَصْلِي, اللي هو, when we say شات مصلية, like grilled sheep. أَصْلِي, الإحراق, to burn. Okay, so أَصْلِي, وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ means we will burn him in the hellfire. And of course, it needs that we drive him to Jahannam. Okay, but exactly, الصلي means الإحراق to burn. ونصله جهنم يعني will burn him in the hellfire. May Allah protect us. وساءت مصيره and evil it is as destination. وساءت مصيره. What we learn from this ayah? The danger of opposing the sunnah and the manhaj of salaf. The danger that we have to follow manhaj al-salaf. It is not optional. It is not optional. Wallahi, this is manhaj ikhwan. This is manhaj salaf. This is ash'ari. This is maturidi. I like to choose this manhaj. It is not food. You have to follow manhaj salaf. You have to. Of course, many people don't like this. It isn't from the Quran and Sunnah. Okay, if you don't like to hear the word manhaj salaf, you have to follow the Quran, the Sunnah, open the understanding of the companions, radiallahu ta'ala, and the best generation. Okay? No, different. Different. They have been different. Ash'ari don't believe in the Tawheed like the Tawheed of Salaf. Ash'ari ma turidi tabligh. They have different ways of. I don't mean no Tawheed. Okay? The six Muslims, they are Muslim, but they have wrong understanding in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Maturidi, Ash'ari, the Kullabi, they have different way of understanding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His attributes. Okay? But when you say different Tawheed, doesn't mean that they worship Jesus. Okay? No doubt, the Muslim, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But when you come to the Tawheed al-Asma wa-Sifat, they have a big problem. Jahmi, Mu'tazila, Asha'ira. Also, we learn from this ayah that we have to follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and not to leave anything of the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all we learn from this ayah that opposing the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way of the believers, after being clear for them. This is the problem. It is clear for you. So why you are opposing that? I show you all the proofs that you have to follow the sunnah. You have to follow the companions. Radiallahu ta'ala, then you are opposing that. This is the problem. Because you know sometimes the people are ignorant. They don't know. They are misguided. But sometimes it is very clear. I show you the proofs from the Quran and sunnah, but you are not following. And also, we learn from this ayah, it is the danger of going astray or going out of the way of the jama'ah. طيب, شوف here. ويتبع غيره سبيل المؤمنين, the way of the believers. The hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, افترقت اليهود على 71 فرقة, النصارى على 72 فرقة, وستفترق هذه أمة على 73 أمة. Jews divided into 71. Christians 72, Muslims 73. Also, there is division. Sects in the Muslim, among the Muslim Ummah. كلها في النار إلا واحدة. All of them, all the sects will be in the hellfire, except one sect. يا رسول الله ما هي الجماعة؟ All sects, all the sects. Yes, 72. Yes. All of them will be in the hellfire except one. Which one? Al-Jama'ah. Al-Jama'ah, the congregation. Another narration explaining this. على مثل ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. Which means the one which is open the my way and the way of my companions. طيب. So here, Al-Jama'ah doesn't mean always the mass of the Muslims, because if the mass wrongdoer or wrong manhaj, you should not follow this. Jama'ah can be one person if you are open the haqq. If you are open the haqq, like Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was alone. His father, his people against him. Alayhi salatu wasalam. So, as it came in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, Al-Jama'ah. Okay, what does it mean, Jama'ah? Any Jama'ah, any group, any congregation? No, upon the haqq. Upon the haqq. And also, they take from this ayah, Hujjiyat al-Ijma'ah. That in Islam, we have something called Ijma'ah. consensus. We have this concept. Why? Because the Prophet, because of this ayah, and also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La tajtami ummati ala dalala." My ummah will not be agreed upon a dalala, a misguidance. So if there is ijma', for sure this is right. If there is ijma', for sure there is right. It is right. Okay, so we are not allowed to mention something different than the ijma'. If there is ijma' among the companions, then we come the next generation, and or after many generations, no, there is another opinion. Okay, from where this other opinion? It started from the fourth generation. No, we will not accept that. The first generation, all of them agreed upon this opinion. Khalas, we should stick to that, because khalas, there is ijma'. If the second opinion came later, we will not accept that. Because how come my ummah, the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, agreed upon something, then after 200-300 years, we discover, no, this is not the correct. Do you mean that the whole years, 200-300 years, Muslims did not know the haqq, and now you know the haqq? All the Muslims were misguided? This cannot happen. This cannot happen. So we have ijma' in the sharia, and that's why it is important to know the ijma'. Why? Because, for example, you said, wallah, I like to study fiqh. Alas, I want to study fiqh. Every single point to study that, to make a research and this. So it is very important for you to know the ijma'. Why? Because if you go and study, maybe you come and you study an issue, and you come to a conclusion, you will not find this among the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So you will be misguided. You will be misguided. So you should know the ijma'. Why? Khalas. If there is ijma' about this, I should not study that. Khalas. I should stick to the ijma'. I know the proofs, why they mention this is as ijma', and khalas, I should stick to that. That's why you'll find, sometimes scholars, when they speak about fiqh issues, they say the proof, the first proof, the second proof, okay, so this will be the opinion if there is no ijma'. But if there is ijma', khalas, I will stick with the ijma'. The ijma' said, one of the issues they mentioned, the blood is najis. The blood is najis, generally. Okay, you'll find some scholars said, when they study the proofs, according to the proofs, no, it is not najis. But they say, but because there is ijma', so I will say with the ijma', with the consensus of the scholars. I'll stay with them. I'll say, this is ijma'. So that's why it is important to know the ijma'. You'll find scholars wrote about the ijma'. And also, I like Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, when you read his book, Usul Fiqh, Al-Usul, Min Ilm Al-Usul, okay, and I think it is translated. And he explained his book. He mentioned one of the points, he said, you'll find scholars saying ijma'. And you'll find opposite opinion, ijma' also. What does he mean, rahimahullah? You'll find a scholar saying, there is ijma', it is wajib. You go to another scholar, you find, there is ijma', it is haram. Like this, something like this, as an example. What does he mean, rahimahullah? He means, we should be careful. Not anyone claims ijma', it is a correct ijma'. Maybe it is not a correct ijma'. Okay, or maybe he means ijma' among, it is ijma' among the Hanbali scholars, only the Hanbali. Okay, we should be careful about this point. Why he's saying ijma'? He means, this is only among the Hanafi. This is ijma' from the Hanafi scholars, not ijma' for all the Muslim ummah. Okay? Also, we learn from this ayah, the danger of opposing the religion of Islam totally. Sometimes you find someone at all, he doesn't like Islam. He's not Muslim. The one who doesn't like Islam is not Muslim for sure. But sometimes there is a point. I am opposing this point practically. So this person would not be, will not say he is kafir. Okay, he is praying, okay, fasting, giving zakah, but he's not doing hajj. Why you are not doing hajj? No, no, I believe hajj is one of the pillars of Islam, but you know, now it is expensive. I should pay maybe 3,000 dinar, 4,000 dinar. He's thinking about money. Will not say he's kafir. He's opposing, but not the whole religion. And he's not opposing because of something by heart. He's opposing because of a desire, a dunya. Will not say kafir, but no doubt this major sin. Also, we learn from this ayah, al-jama'a rahmah. Being in a jama'ah or the unity is a mercy. So there is a hadith, but not authentic hadith, ikhtilaf ummati rahmah. The differences among my ummah, this is rahmah, this is mercy. This is wrong meaning and also not authentic hadith. Wallahi, strange. Okay, you are praying according to Hanbali, okay, mabruk, yalla. According to Shafi'i, yalla, mabruk. I leave the Muslims like that. No, we should try to unite the Muslims. We should try to unite. I don't mean that we fight the four madahib. The four madahib are there and the scholars teaching that. But how to apply the madhab? How to apply? Okay, I see you, wallahi, praying in a way. I believe it is not sunnah. So, but I know that you are following Hanafi. Khalas, I leave it, you are following Hanafi. Or following Shafi'i, following... No, if I know a proof from Quran, authentic Sunnah, I tell you in a nice way. Assalamu alaikum, brother. This is the Prophet ﷺ was doing this, this, like this. So I advise him. What is the problem? Why? Because we want to the Muslim to unite upon the Sunnah. To unite upon the Sunnah. Again, maybe some people say, well, Sheikh, we should not... يعني, haram to study the madhab. I don't mean haram. But the furqa adab. يعني, you know, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen mentioned during his time, rahimahullah, maybe when he was a child, he said there were four imam in the haram, in the masjid al-haram. Hanafi, Maliki, Shafi'i, Hanbali. This is good that there are four jama'ah in the masjid al-haram, or to have one jama'ah now. No, that to have one jama'ah, one imam, one salah, jama'ah. This is better. No doubt. So the importance of being in one jama'ah, to unite. وَاعْتَصِمُوا Allah says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ The robe of Allah, the Quran. So we should work hard to unite. Open the sunnah. But if I leave, okay, let him, because he is Hanafi, let him, this is Shafi'i. What will happen? The Muslim woman will be weak. And we are weak now. يعني سبحان الله, this is because of, I'm talking about the fiqh, so what about the aqidah? This is more dangerous. Okay, leave him. This, okay, this is Ash'ari, خلاص, leave him Ash'ari. This is Maturidi, and this is Sufi. Leave them, leave them. This is more dangerous than the fiqh issues. When you leave people, and, we are not united upon a correct aqidah. Mushkila. That's why we are weak. How to fight our enemy, I mean the non-Muslim enemy, if the Muslims among themselves, we are different sects. We are different sects. And you can notice, subhanAllah, how many sects in the among the Muslim ummah. If there is a war between the Muslims and the non-Muslims, you'll find the Muslims fighting each other. And maybe sometimes you'll find some of the Muslims focusing on the other Muslim, not the real enemy. SubhanAllah. So al-jama'ah rahmah, wal-furqa adab. Okay, being jama'ah, this is mercy. Furqa, this is punishment. Adab. But again, what do you mean by jama'ah? Upon the sunnah. And also, you cannot save yourself without following the sunnah. If you want to save yourself, follow the sunnah. If you go astray here or there, خلاص, there is no other way. There is no other way. There is only one way to reach paradise, which is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the manhaj salaf. There's only one way. طيب. And also we learn from this ayah, يعني the danger of opposing the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم during his life and also opposing his sunnah after his death. And also we learn from this ayah, الدين واضح, Islam, the religion of Islam is clear. يعني it is not something hidden, something I need to put under microscope to know the haq واضح. الحمد لله. Allah is our Lord. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is our messenger. And this is the Salah, the pillars of Islam, pillars of Islam. Everything is clear. الحمد لله. In the Quran, what we read many times, بينات. What does it mean بينات? Clear, واضح. Clear, by. Yes, the proofs. The proofs are واضح, clear. And also, this is a virtue for the Muslim Ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this criteria that we will not gather upon the misguidance. Alhamdulillah. If you follow the way of the non-Muslim, if you follow the way of the non-Muslims about the dunya, the ayah doesn't talk about the dunya. The ayah talks about the religious issues. So if I follow the non-Muslim way and something worldly in life, no problem. No problem in that. Yani for example, if there is a way of transportation, we saw this from a kuffar country. Can we follow? You can follow. This is about transportation or communication. No problem about the dunya. I mean, if it is not haram. The ayah here talks about the way of religion. The way of religion. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ وَمَن يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. Indeed, Allah does not forgive association with him, but he forgives what is less than that for whom he wills, and he who associates others with Allah has certainly gone for astray. So this is the second time. This ayah, okay, came in the Quran and Surah Nisa two times. The first part. Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih wa yaghfiru ma duna dhalika liman yasha. Okay, this is a very important ayah. It is a very important ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive the shirk, which means when the person dies as mushrik. But with repentance, Allah forgives all the sins. Allah says in surah, the other surah, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَى أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgives all sins. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah doesn't forgive shirk. The other ayah, Allah forgives all sins. How? This ayah means Allah doesn't forgive the shirk when the person dies as mushrik. But the other ayah, Allah forgives all sins after repentance. If you repent, Allah will forgive you the sin, whatever your sin. So this ayah is a very important ayah. Number one, we learn from this ayah the danger of shirk. The danger of shirk. In Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih. And also, this ayah, Allah, يعني, it tells you the danger of all types of shirk. يعني, some scholars say, Allah will not forgive the shirk, even the minor shirk. You know, major shirk and minor shirk. Some scholars say this ayah talks about the major shirk, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive the major shirk. And some scholars said also this ayah includes the minor shirk. How? He's Muslim, but he's committing minor shirk. So at the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive this minor shirk. So for sure he will be punished because of the minor shirk. But then he will be in paradise. No doubt the minor shirk is a major sin. Okay, major sin. But we should be careful from all types of shirk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. The scholars use this ayah, okay, against the Khawarij. Because the Khawarij say, no, if you commit any major sin, you are a kafir. هي ذا آية. الله سيد يو ار اندر ذا ويل اوف الله سبحانه وتعالى. طيب ومن يشرك بالله فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا. طيب هي مس جايدد ذا ون هو داز شرك. الله سيرتني شو اسمه سوري and he who associates others with Allah has certainly gone far astray. فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا. Not only any misguidance. No, this is very far misguidance. The one who does shirk بالله سبحانه وتعالى. So if you notice here, as I said, Allah سبحانه repeated talk about the shirk, the danger of shirk. Why? Because we should be very careful from shirk. That's why we should speak also a lot about shirk. Hudhayfa radiyallahu ta'ala an said, كان الناس يسألون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الخير وكنت أسأله عن الشر مخافة أن أقع فيه. People used to ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about the good. The virtues of salah, the virtues of zakah, how to be in paradise, how to be the firdaus. People used to ask him about khair. وكنت أسأله عن الشر and I used to ask him about the evil. Why? مخافة أن أقع فيه. To avoid it. So this ayah is one of the proofs to tell you the importance of learning the shirk and teaching people the shirk. Why you are talking about shirk? Alhamdulillah, we are Muslims. We are here in the masjid. Why you are talking about shirk? We should talk about shirk to avoid it. You should teach people, you should learn the shirk. Yani subhanAllah, you'll find who are talking mainly about the shirk in details. The Salafi scholars. The other sects, you will not find them talking about shirk. Or if they speak about shirk, they will speak generally. Showing you that shirk means you put an idol and make sujood to the idol. They will not speak about the details of shirk. Or if they are khawarij, okay, or like the khawarij, they will speak about the shirk of the rulers and not following the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They call shirk al-qubur and shirk al-qusur. There is shirk of the graves and there is shirk of the qusur, the palaces. You should speak about all kinds of shirk. You should make it clear for people, but also you should be careful not to declare that the Muslim rulers are not Muslims, they are so and so. Because of what? Misunderstanding, wrong understanding. So we should study the shirk and we should teach people what are the shirk, the types of shirk. Major shirk and minor shirk. And subhanAllah, the famous book about, talk about the shirk in details, Kitab Tawheed by Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab. We should study this book, we should read this book. Not specifically because of the book or because of the author, because it makes it easy for us to understand. Is it wajib to study Kitab Tawheed? Some people show you why should I study Kitab Tawheed? Allah mentioned the Quran that we should study Kitab Tawheed. We don't say you have to study Kitab Tawheed. We don't say, wallah, you have to study all the works of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab or Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah. Yes, you should study the Quran and Sunnah, but they help us to make it easy for us, to classify for us. SubhanAllah, those people who are speaking like that, okay, who is Muhammad Abdul Wahab? It is not mentioned in the Quran, Muhammad Abdul Wahab. It is not mentioned in the Quran, Kitab Tawheed. Okay? This kind of people, they will not follow the Sunnah. SubhanAllah. So this ayah is a great ayah. Very important ayah. And also we learn from the ayah that the forgiveness of other sins, less than the shirk, not sure. Don't read the ayah and say, okay, no problem with any sin other than shirk. No, there is a problem. Allah says, وَيَغْفِرْ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. If he wills. And if he doesn't will, he will punish the person. Then he will be in paradise, the Muslim. And subhanAllah, when you are far from the haqq, then the repentance will be more difficult. Be careful. Don't go astray. And don't continue in going astray. try to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we learn from this ayah that the tawheed is the best ma'roof. It is the greatest ma'roof. I mean the greatest righteous deed, the tawheed. Also, we learn this from this ayah, the great hope in our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever you do, the sins, okay, don't lose the hope. Allah will forgive the sins if He wills. I mean, if they are less than shirk. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may forgive some sins, not all the sins. The person has a lot of sins. Backbiting, slandering, not giving zakah, not praying some of the days of Ramadan. So not to say Allah forgives all the sins. Maybe Allah forgives some of your sins and the other sins will be punished. But the main thing, you should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should repent to Allah and you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the acceptance. And also we learn from this ayah, as we mentioned, we should keep teaching people the danger of shirk and the ties of shirk. Speak about the shirk in details. Teach people what are the ties of shirk, the danger of shirk. Let people know what are the ties of shirk. And also, as I said, this is a very clear proof for Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah against the Khawarij. The Khawarij, yallah, you are kafir. You stole something, you are kafir. You did zina, adultery, you are kafir. You drank khamr, you are kafir. This eye is against them. A great proof for Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Finally, no hasana will be useful with shirk. I mean the major shirk. Like Abdullah ibn Jad'an. Aisha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Rasulullah, Abdullah ibn Jad'an, he was doing something great, feeding the needy. Will be this beneficial for him? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّهُ لَمْ يَقُلْ يَوْمًا رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي خَطِيئَتِي يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. He did not say one time, oh Allah, forgive me my sins. Which means he was not Muslim. He was not Muwahid. So all of his great deeds will be useless. These deeds will not help him from the hellfire at the day of judgment. Jazakumullah khairan. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.